Hey YouTube, Savon Draws here with some good news. Clip Studio 4.0 is finally out with quite a few new features. But before we get into it, I'd just like to announce quickly that I started memberships on the channel. If you ever want to get early videos or tutorials, you can just hit the membership button. Or if you just want to donate to the channel, all the support helps. Now let's get into these features. So we have new features for both animation and art in this new update. And first off, we have new brush and opacity sliders, which is great for touchscreens. It basically makes us have a window that we can open where we can just drag our brush or opacity like Procreate or a lot of different mobile applications for art. And that just helps not having to dig up the brush size window in Clip Studio, which is kind of annoying because it slides horizontally instead of vertically and takes up more space on your canvas. I think this was already in the tablet version, but I'm guessing now it's coming to the PC version of Clip Studio Paint in 4.0 as well. Now, a new feature we have that I think is actually pretty revolutionary is a magnetic lasso. And basically we can activate this lasso just by going to the brush settings for our lasso. Then after we're in our settings, we'll hit lasso and we'll activate magnetic lasso. Then as you can see, when we're lassoing around our line art, the lasso will magnetize itself to our lines. And basically this will help us to fill in our lines very extremely easily because we don't need to worry about gaps in our lines for our fill tool. We just use the magnetic lasso and it basically makes it work much more efficiently. Moving forward, if we go to edit, then transform, we now have a new tool called the puppet warp, which helps us to distort our character much more efficiently. So the way we do this is we just set up different points, kind of like bones for our drawings. And then we can move limbs or just parts of our drawing that we want to move more precisely. Basically, the more points you set up, that's where it will control how your character moves. You may want to set up more points if you want to move your character more precisely. I just recommend setting it up at whatever points you want to bend. As you can see here, I made a stick figure and I totally changed his pose from where we started, and it actually still looks like a proper drawing. So that's really dope. I even was able to move like a finished drawing in Clip Studio here. Moving forward, we have new snap tools, which will basically help us to snap both vectors and snap our lines to rulers. So the first thing we can do is we can, if we are using a vector layer, we can go to view, then we can go to snap, and then go snap to object. After doing all this, when we move our objects, we'll see bounding boxes that basically are just snapping and aligning the objects to each other based off however you set it up. So this will be very good for text and just, you know, designing vectors in here. Now, I know we could already draw snapping to our rulers, but they may have changed the way that it's done. But basically, we can just easily set up a perspective drawing by using our rulers and snapping to them. Here, I'm just snapping to the perspective as I draw, and then I'm using the vector erase brush to erase all the lines that are overlapping each other. Moving on to 3D, another pretty cool feature we have is that now we can paint on our 3D models directly. So this would be great for just setting up how we want to paint drawings, if we want to actually include our 3D model in our exported drawing, or if we want to use like draw guides on top of our 3D model for when we actually draw. I think there's a lot of potential use cases for this, so I hope to see what you guys do with that. And the way to activate this is you just put a 3D model on your canvas and you select your drawing tool and draw away. Another 3D update is that now we can just cast shadows from one 3D object to another 3D object, which will probably help us to determine lighting if we're using 3D to draw as a reference. So the way we do this is after we place our 3D model, we just have to basically click the little wrench icon to go to the settings. Then we have to click light source. We have to click apply light source. We have to click cast shadows, and then we have to click the drop down, and we either have to click apply to 3D models only or apply to models and ground. Then we'll see as we move our character around, the light source still follows our character, and we can edit the light source just by clicking around the sphere material at the top that shows where the material is being lighted from. Now that all the 3D updates are done, we can finally get to the animation updates, and we really just have a few quality of life changes here. To do this, first we have to color code the folders or the layers in the layers tab. So we can color code them just by clicking on the individual layer to color code a specific cell or frame. And then we can also color code the animation layer itself, so we cover a color for the whole animation layer. Also, when you make a new frame, it will keep the same color as the last cell that you made. Finally, now when you import videos, you'll be given a prompt to separate the audio track from your video so you can have a new audio layer. And if you see, it will play back just like this. But it will not play when you actually try to render your animation. Last but not least, we have two quality of life changes that are not related to animation. We can now multi-select all of our tools in Clip Studio, and we can basically use it for organization or deleting multiple things at once. So that will be very helpful in terms of time. All we have to do this is click the little checkbox at the bottom left of our tools, and then we can select away. Finally, now when we're setting up our files, we can make sure our time lapse is more efficient on saving space. We just make a new file and then we go to prioritize file size, and it will make the file size smaller overall. If you don't have Clip Studio already, it's on sale for the next few days, so you may want to consider picking it up soon. I'll leave a link in the description for you guys to check out. So that's about it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please like and subscribe. Consider becoming a member for early access to videos and tutorials. And I'll see you guys soon.